Lady Bugs, this is your girl Lady L, aka Buildable Beauty, aka Blenderella, and I'm coming at you guys today to give you some quick tips on how to go from armpit length APL to bra strap length BSL. And these are just some tips that I found helpful along my journey. I wish I would have had someone to tell me these things that I'm about to tell you guys, because it seems so simple, but it could really after a long time, after doing it often, it could do some damage. So these are some quick minor tips that will just help you along the way to give you, you know, some insight on what's to come, because it is a difference when you go from one length to another length. Number one, retaining length. This is key. At this point, if you're already APL and you're moving towards BSL, you should already have a regimen in place. I know we all have a lot of project junkie in us, but at this point, you should have a stable regimen, and you may want to try something here and there, but trying something on the weekly, daily, you know, it could really hurt you in the long term. You want to have your hair trained at this point. Number two, protect the styling. Once you're APL, you're able to wear your hair in a bun, some cute little updos, ponytail, whatever you want to do. Like I have a little side bun thing going on here. Real quick, easy buns are the easiest thing. At this point, you just want to just throw it up anyway. Number three, wash in the shower. I stated this last time on an SL to APL video. Wash in the shower. I wish I had somebody tell me this from the beginning and I would have been doing it. But I can't stress that enough. Wash in the shower. You want everything going in the same direction, not fighting against that direction. Number four, have a good detangler on deck. I cannot speak enough about detanglers. Even if you don't use it, you may have a good conditioner that just does have a lot of mega slip, and you don't. But you need something on deck just in case one of those days you come across a knot. Just have something on deck. You don't have to use it, but just have something that you like in the cabinet. Number five. Watch out for ragged or chipped nails. This is something that I find very helpful. I had to remove my fingernail polish just because it was chipping, and I co-washed my hair the other day, so I had to remove it before I even touched my hair or washed my hair, because I know that my hair will probably get lodged underneath one of those chipped nails. So I'm very mindful when it's time for washing my hair, co-washing my hair, anything to do with putting my fingers in my head, if my nails are chipped, ragged, jagged, or anything, even your nail polish, because sometimes hair can lodge in between those two, or little chips, or little cracks in your nails. So be very mindful. Something that small will take a little chip out of your hair. Watch out for fabric and clothes. The fall is coming up on us. Winter is coming on us. It don't seem like it, but it's coming. And you have to be mindful of wool, very strong cottons and stuff like that, hats and caps and whatnot. I know you want to bundle up, but you still have to be very mindful of protecting your hair while you do that. One method I find in the wintertime, if I want to wear a cap or you know what they call a tammy or bonnet or whatever, I'll put on my satin cap first, then I will put on any kind of winter gear or anything like that. So you just gotta protect your hair at all times. Do not be afraid to rock your satin in public. Okay. Number seven, handbag straps. Oh my, it is so annoying. I try to avoid this at all costs. Straps of handbags, and when you're wearing your hair down, I wish I could demonstrate now, but or maybe I could take my bun loose, but this, okay, I have my hair now, and I have a bag, and woof, a strap. These two things could lead to you losing some strands. Okay, you have to be very mindful of the strap and your hair, because you can, when you want your hair down and you just put a strap on it, the pressure, if your bag is heavy, the pressure from that could cause you to lose a couple of strands. And it's just irritating to me. It does. So I'm very mindful just to put my hair to the side if I have on a bag with a strap. put my hair to the side and then rock it like that. But it always is. Oh my goodness, that is so annoying. So watch out for straps, handbag straps. Number 8, rings, chains, and just any kind of jewelry. All I'm rocking this ring. I just want to demonstrate. This ring has I would call it like accordion style banding. So I mean, if I rub my hands through my hair could possibly snag on this ring because of the accordion style banding. So you have to be very careful of things like this. Another thing, earrings. Sometimes we have these big, nice earrings, elaborate decorative earrings, not knowing that if you have your hair hanging down, that it could get snagged in there. It's happened to me. I've had to pull a strand or two out of an earring. So that's not a fun thing. Once you do that, you're going to be very mindful of putting your hair back or just not wearing that piece of jewelry when you're wearing your hair down. Another thing, necklaces. I wouldn't dare wear this necklace with my hair hanging. Reason being, it has my hair get caught in here any kind of way. It could get tangled, twisted, and you know, if I try to take the jewelry off, this has happened. If I try to take a chain off and a piece of hair is kind of caught and you're kind of manipulating and trying to get it out, that's a headache. Just be mindful of the jewelry that you're wearing. And I could never wear this with my hair hanging down, but that's this is something that I like to wear when it's up. So yeah, you can just be mindful of what you're doing. These are just a couple of little tips that have helped me along the way. You'll learn, you'll navigate through it, but it's always good to have a heads up. But if you're APL and you're going to BSL and you're in between, congratulations, and just happy hair growing.